Haverly Digital Media and Entertainment presents How to Hug a Porcupine, Easy Ways to Love the Difficult People in Your Life. Narrated by Julie Briskman. How to Hug a Porcupine is also available in print and ebook editions from Haverly Press Limited, wherever books are sold. Foreword by Dr. Debbie Jaffe Ellis. This book is a powerful tool. In fact, it is a tool so powerful that if we practice its recommendations, it can lead us towards harmony, compassion, and a better world. How? This book reminds us that we humans have the capacity to create our attitudes and emotions, as well as our actions. If we choose to, we can maintain inner peace despite difficult outer circumstances. We can prevent unnecessary suffering. If you allow your quills of judgment to turn inwards and pierce you, this book can help you to foster self-acceptance. If you make yourself angry at others who prick you by acting in harmful and provocative ways, the strategies offered in this book will enable you to calm and stabilize yourself. And if you mistakenly allow yourself to be pierced by others, the wisdom of the words in the book reminds you not to take it too personally. With thoughtful, easy-to-follow strategies, How to Hug a Porcupine shows you how to embrace the porcupine tendency while still respecting the quills. You can learn to unconditionally accept yourself as well as others. The brilliant pioneering psychologist, Albert Ellis, Ph.D., taught that no one can upset us unless we allow them to. Instead, we can choose to think rationally, feel calm, and act with consideration, kindness, and empathy. We can learn not to think and act irrationally, and not to automatically stick our quills out during threatening or provocative situations. Even if the porcupinely acting person who you are dealing with resists, your open-hearted approach will not be wasted. Every time we practice kindness, compassion, and unconditional acceptance of others, we are reinforcing it within and for ourselves. How to Hug a Porcupine makes change for a lifetime possible. This is a book that can be picked up, enjoyed, and implemented at any time. In fact, it will benefit us tremendously to consult it regularly. We all benefit from reminders, and repeating these exercises will erode persistent negative tendencies. Keep practicing these principles over and over again. Share this book with others, and set an example by modeling its principles. Life is brief. Time is precious. Wasting it in defense and attack, or in anger and fear, is regretful. Choose instead to practice patience, empathy, compassion, kindness, understanding, and unconditional acceptance. Work towards creating greater harmony within yourself and in your relationships, and you will contribute to creating a healthier, saner world. This book can be used as a dose of preventative medicine, a first aid kit, and a healing balm. But more than anything else, it is an effective tool for emotional and mental health and well-being. Turn to it to encourage greater awareness of heart and mind. Use it in your own life and you will bring stability, peace, and joy to yourself, others, and the world around you. Dr. Debbie Jaffe Ellis. A note from the publisher. We all know people who are difficult to be around. We may run into them at work, at home, through friends, or simply whenever we are going through our day. Unfortunately, those porcupines are not going to go away. On the following pages, you will find strategies for dealing with those prickly personalities. This is important not only because we simply don't have a choice but to deal with porcupines, but also because it is actually good for us to find ways to get along with those who are different from us. Other people challenge us. Other people improve us. Other people make us better human beings. Andrew Flack, publisher. Part 1. The Nature and Being of the Porcupine. The supreme happiness of life is the conviction that we are loved. Loved for ourselves, or rather, loved in spite of ourselves. Victor Hugo. Why porcupines? For centuries, cultures from around the world have used animal characteristics to identify and describe human personality traits. In Native American culture, for example, everybody in the community must undergo a mystical rite of passage to identify their animal spirit. This animal then becomes part of their name. Examples include Sitting Bull and Little Turtle. The Chinese zodiac assigns one of 12 animals to every year, and an individual's personality is believed to be reflected in the attributes of the animal that was appointed the year that one was born. The animal characters in Aesop's fables embody different attributes of human behavior, and their stories and predicaments offer lessons on human nature. Today, expressions like stubborn as a mule, wise as an elephant, and sly as a fox are still sprinkled throughout conversation. Whether these expressions, stories, or themes are accurate or not, the way mankind draws links between animal behavior and human behavior reveals a great deal about our struggle to understand ourselves and each other. This book seeks to help you, the reader, understand and cope with a certain type of person. Those individuals who are difficult and challenging. We call these people porcupines. Why? To answer that, we need to look at the actual behavior and habits of the porcupine. The porcupine in nature. Porcupines are rodents whose coats feature modified spiny hairs known as quills. These quills are embedded in the skin, and a single porcupine may have over 30,000 quills in his coat. There are 27 species of porcupine, divided into two families. Those found in the Old World, Europe, Asia, and Africa, and the New World, the Americas and Australia. Porcupine ancestors date from 30 million years ago. Old World porcupines live on the ground, while New World porcupines are avid tree climbers. Although some species of porcupine eat small reptiles and insects in addition to a diet of bark, roots, fruit, meadow grass, and tubers, most species of porcupines are strictly herbivores. They eat only vegetables. Unlike most herbivores, who have to seek safety in numbers, the effectiveness of the porcupine's quills as a defense against predators allows it to lead a solitary life. Even today, porcupines are generally misunderstood. Contrary to a legend which dates back to the Greek philosopher Aristotle, porcupines cannot throw or fire their quills. Nor are their quills poisonous. Their name itself is a misnomer. It derives from the Latin words porcus and spina, which together mean thorny pig. Porcupines are neither thorny, nor are they related to pigs. They are, in fact, most similar to beavers in habitat, diet, and temperament. Porcupine babies, called porcupettes, are born with soft, pliable quills. Within a matter of hours, these harden into defensive weapons. The porcupine threatened. When porcupines are threatened, tiny muscles at the base of each quill tighten, causing their quills to stand up and the porcupine to appear much larger than it really is. Then the porcupine will rattle its quills, grunt, growl, and stamp its feet, all in an effort to scare off its attacker. If the predator persists, the porcupine will turn its back, raising its tail and crouching defensively. Finally, the porcupine will charge backwards, whack the predator with its tail, or throw its body at its attacker. This often leaves a handful of quills embedded painfully in its opponent. Over time, the quills can work their way into the flesh of the attacker and cause infection. Despite its unappetizing quills and highly developed counterattack, the porcupine is still vulnerable to larger carnivorous predators. One predator, the American fisher, has evolved a technique for getting around the porcupine's quills. It flips the porcupine onto its back, exposing its tender and undefended underbelly. How are people like porcupines? Human porcupines would probably be indistinguishable from anyone else, except for their reaction to any kind of threat or incursion. It's then that, like the porcupine in nature, they puff themselves up to try to scare off their adversary. Unfortunately, this defensive behavior in the human porcupine is too little too late in many ways. That is, the human porcupine only reveals himself when you've already stepped into his bubble, and he is already on the defensive. How do you make up for encroaching on his territory, fix the situation, and determine the best way to avoid future confrontation? Learning more about the human porcupine and adapting your behavior is the first step. Part 2. A Basic Guide to Understanding Porcupines. Love one another and you will be happy. It's as simple and as difficult as that. Michael Lunig. What follows are some specific techniques to help you not only survive, but thrive in your encounters with human porcupines. No matter where you encounter a porcupine, whether you are meeting him for the first time or have known her for years, having some reliable strategies in your back pocket can make all the difference in the world. With knowledge and the right attitude on your side, you can not only make the best out of a bad situation, but, with practice, learn how to avoid painful spots altogether. Here are ways to cope with any prickly porcupine with humor, wisdom, and practicality. Learn your porcupine's warning signs. For human porcupines, their quills are most often their words, delivered aggressively, with fierce language, and often in a loud voice. Learn to recognize these warning signs so that you can be one step ahead when your porcupine gets aggressive. Keep your quills in. A porcupine's defensive behavior can be contagious. During a disagreement with a porcupine, many people will resort to their own defensive mode. Don't. There is a very big difference between trying to understand what is bothering your porcupine and getting into a big fight. So, take a step back, take a deep breath, and try again. Don't let your own quills get the best of you. Respect your porcupine's boundaries. The attack of a porcupine is a last resort of a frightened, cornered creature trying to keep a threat at bay. We should always remember this. Because a porcupine often attacks out of fear, respecting his boundaries will keep him from lashing out. Consider your porcupine's real needs and fears. It's important to remember that human porcupines, like porcupettes, are born soft. But bad experiences, fears, and failed relationships have forced them to harden their exteriors and sharpen their quills. We should keep in mind that a porcupine's quills, the result of past injuries, are a part of who the porcupine is, and they aren't necessarily meant to hurt us. This perspective helps us relate to the porcupine and provides us with the understanding we need to successfully approach her. Find that soft spot. Even porcupines have soft spots, their belly. Keep in mind that although it may require some close attention and careful strategy, you can find your human porcupine's emotional soft spot. This will be a topic that, no matter what, brings a smile to his face and makes him feel good whenever he talks about it. It could include a passion, a favorite hobby, or anecdotes about a loved one.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.